Good morning to one and all present here. I'm Sushil Joshi and you're watching The Math Magic. In today's lecture, we're going to learn the part 2 of the multiples and factor. That is, we are going to learn the factors in today's class of class 5th maths. Here, you will get the complete explanation with all questions are covered in this topic. So if you like my video, then don't forget to subscribe and share. Here we go, our first topic. Factors. As you know that, before going towards the actual topic, we'll try to learn the definition of the topic, that is factors. So what do you mean by n factor? So first I write it. This is our today's topic, factor. A factor is a number. When you divide it by the other number and if you get the remainder as zero, at that time, that divisor is called as a factor of that number. So in simple way, we will try to learn what do you mean by n factor. Again, I will repeat it. When a number exactly, that means completely, divide when a number exactly divide by the other number, then that number is called factor of that number. So this is the definition. Again, I read it. When a number exactly divided by the other number, then that number is called factor of that number. That number means original number. So how we explain it? We'll take an example. That example will definitely clear you the idea of factor that we are going to learn today. This is our first example. When a number, so let us take a number in your mind. Suppose 6 is that number, is exactly divided by other number and let the other number be 2. Then what we got here? So I divide it. Look here. Here 6, I write here 2. I read the table of 2 up to 6, 2, 3 is 6, so I write here 3, 6 minus 6, 0, this is called as the quotient, this is called as the divisor, this is called as the dividend, and this is called as the remainder. So what is the definition? Is exactly divided by. Exactly divided means we got the remainder 0, leaving no remainder. At that time, that number means here 2. 2 is called the factor of 6. So here I write, 2 is called factor of 6. In this way, you will find the factor of any number if you got the remainder as 0. So let us take another example. We'll try to find out the factors of different numbers. How we'll find it? Question number 2. Find all factors of 12. This question is given to us. Find all factors of 12. So again, a very simple trick is given to you. I will tell you. Learn this trick. This is very easy trick. To finding a factor of any number, that means check by how many numbers this number is divisible. That means check 12. So I write here, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you have to check whether this 12 is present in all these numbers table or not. If this is present in the table of that number, that means this number is a factor of 12. So how we check it? As you know that every number is present in the table of 1. That means 1 is a factor of every number. What we got here? 1 is a factor of every number. Check whether 12 is present in any numbers table starting from 1 up to 12. 1 up to 12. If it is present, then that number is a factor of 12. So what we got here? Look here. We got here 1. 1 12 is a 12. Again, I read the table of 2. 2 1 is a 2. 2 2 is a 4. 2 3 is a 6. 2 4 is a 8. 2 5 is a 10. And 2 6 is a 12. So 12 is also present in the table of 2. So I write here 2. 2 is again a factor of 12. Then I read the table of 3. 3 1 is a 3. 3 2 is a 6. 3 3 is a 9. 3 4 is a 12. So 12 is present in the table of 3. So I write here 3. Then I read the table of 4. 4 1 is a 4. 4 2 is a 8. 4 3 is a 12. Again I write 4 here. 4 is a factor. So 5. I read the table of 5. 5 1 is a 5. 5 2 is a 10. 5 3 is a 15. That means we are not find the 12 in the table of 5. So I do not write here 5. Then we move towards the table of 6. Look here. Then we move toward the table of 6. 6 1 is a 6. 6 2 is a 12. That means 6 is present because 12 is present in the table of 6. Then we move towards the 7. 7 1 is a 7. 7 2 is a 14. So 7 is not a factor of 12. So I tick the numbers whose present in the table of 12 is present in that table. In the 8, 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 16, 8 is not. 9 1 is 9, 9 2 is 18, 9 is also not. 10 is also not, and 11 is also not. So what is left here? 12. 12 is present in the table of 12. So right here, 12. So what are the possible factors of 12? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. These are all the factors. All the factors of 12. So in this way, you can easily find out the factors of any number if you know the different tables of different numbers. At least, student, you have to learn the table up to 30 by heart so that you can easily find out the factors of any numbers up to 30. There is another trick associated with this 12. So how we can find out the different parts of the different factors? From this example, we got One new thing, if you understand this example carefully, you will observe that important note is there. Please remember this note. From above example, we observe that one is a factor of every number. Number two, the number itself. The number itself is a factor of that number. That means 12 is a factor of 12. These two things we have learned from this example. I hope this example will clear you the idea of factor. Again, we will try to find out a factor of 10. Suppose next question is given to you. Find all factors of 10. This question is given to you. So what do we do? So write or read the table of different numbers. As you know that 1 is a factor of every number. So 1 and 10, these two factors are given to us. Then again, read the table of 2. 2, 5 is a 10. So I write here 2. As 10 is an even number, so most possibility it is present in the very few tables up to 10. 1 is there, 2 is there, then 3, 3 is a 9, and 3, 4 is a 12. 3 is not a factor of 10. Write down this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1 is there, 2, 5 is a 10 is there, 3 is not there, 4 is not there because 4, 4, 3 is a 12, 4, 2 is a 8. 5, 2 is a 10, 5 is there, 6 is not there, 7 is not there, 8 is not there, 9 is and 10. So I write here 1, 2, 5 and 10. These 4 are the factors of 12. Again, another method, how we find it, look here. There is one interesting method, a prime factorization method to find out the factors of any number. Before that, you have to know what do you mean by the prime factors. Here we go, we will learn. First, we write the even number, definition of even number. Even number numbers that are divisible by two are called even numbers. Example 2, 10, 14, 26, 38, 50, like this. So what do you observe that in another way we can say that the numbers having 2, 4, 6, 8, 0 at its unit place, that numbers are called as even numbers. Again, I repeat it, the numbers having 2, 4, 6, 8 and 0 at its unit place, that numbers are called as even numbers. So what do you mean by the odd numbers? Odd numbers. The numbers that are not divisible by 2 are called odd numbers. For example, 1, 3, 5, 7, so on. Here also you can write so many numbers, so on, are called odd numbers. And what do we mean by the prime numbers? This is the most important part, because we are going to learn the prime factorization method to find out the factors. Prime numbers. Numbers having only two factors, that is, are called as prime numbers. Example, 2, 5, 7, 11, so on. So what we get from this definition? That means those numbers which are present in the table of 1 and their self table are called as the prime numbers. Those number which are present in the table of 1 and their own table are called as prime numbers. In another way, we can write a number that is divisible by itself and 1, or you can write it a number which is divisible by 1 and itself is called prime number. So here you can learn any two definitions of prime number. This is very important. Now we will going to learn the prime factorization method to find out the factors of different prime numbers. This is our first example. Find the factors of 24 using prime factorization method. This is our first question. So how we will find it? Look here. First, I draw a line like this. Then again, I divide the line in this way. I write here 24. And starting from 2, I will try to divide this 24. As you know that 1 is not a prime number. To find out the prime factorization means divide this number only by prime numbers, and that divisor is called as the prime factors of that number. So first, remember that 1 is not a prime number. So you do not take 1 here. So start from 2. So I will divide the 24 by 2. 2 1 the 2. I will take 4 here. 2 2 the 4. So write here 12. So first I write here 12. Here we are dividing by. Again divide this 12 by 2. Why 12 by 2? As just we see that 2 is at the unit place. This place is called as a unit place. So whenever a number having 2, 4, 680 at its unit place, that number is divisible by 2. So here 2 is there, so again divide it by 2. Read the table of 2 up to 12, 2 6 is 12, so write here 6. As you know that, just we see that the 2 4 6 8 0, 6 is there, so again it is divisible by 2. So 2 3 is 6, but here 3 is divided by 3, so I write here 3 1 is 3. So whenever 1, we got 1 is there, so stop here, no need to write down again the number, so write here prime factors of 24 is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3. In this way you can write down the prime factors by using the prime factorization method. I hope all of you understand. So let us take another example. It will definitely clear you the idea of prime factorization method. We take the larger example one. Find the factors of 98. Suppose this number is given to us. What is your first step? Draw this line, draw a line like this, then write here 98. As you know that, just we will see 24680 at its unit place, so it is there. So this number is divided by 2, so I write here 2. We will try to divide it here. 2 4 is 8, 9 minus 8, we got 1 here. We put 8 over here, so 2 9 is 18. 1 minus 1, 8 minus 8, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. So we got here 49. So write here 49. Again, 9 is there. So find out in which number we will find the 49. As you know that in the table of 7, if you read the table of 7, 7 1 is 7, 7 2 is 14, 3 is 21, 4 is 28, 5 is 35, 6 is 42, and 7 7 is 49. That means this 49 is divisible by 7. So I write here 7. 7 and I write here 7 here. 7 7 is 49. Again, this 7 is divided by 7. So I write here 7 1 is 7. So here we get 1. So you have to stop here and you have to write the prime factors. Factors of 98 is equal to 2 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 7. By using the prime factorization method. In this way, you will find out the different prime factors of different numbers. But remember one thing, start from 2. Important note, start from 2 if the number is even number. If the number is even number. Learn the definition of even number, odd number, and prime number. Start from 2 if the number is even number. I hope all of you understand this topic. Then we will turn toward the next topic. This is also a very important topic with respect to your class 5th. This is going to be asked in next class also, that is factors by using the factor tree. Important part, factors using factor tree. So what do you mean by a factor tree? As you know that, have you seen a Bunyan tree? The roots of the Bunyan tree goes from upward to downward, as you know that. So like this, you have to find out the factors of a number like a Bunyan tree. That means its branches are, you have to draw the branches of that number from upward to downward. How we will find it? Look here. Suppose a question is given to you, find out the factors of 24. Same question we'll take here by using factor tree. Find factors of following number using factor tree. Question number A, 48. Question number B, 24. Question number C, 50. So suppose these three questions are given to us. First, we will write here 48. So like banyan tree, write down the 48 first. I write here 48. Then divide 48. As you know that 8 is there at unit place. This number is an even number and this number is also divisible by 2. So I divide it by 2. I divide 48 like this by 2. 2 2s are 4. 8 is there. 2 4s are 8. So we got here 24. So I write here 2 and here 24. Again, this 24 is divisible by 2. As you know that the 4 is present at the unit place of 24. So 24 is also divisible by 2. So I divide 24 by 2. 2 1s are 2. 4 is there. 2 2s are 4. So we write here 24 as 2 and 12. Again, this 12. First, I remove it because we have to write down here. I hope all of you understand. So what is next step? Again, this 12 is divisible by 2 as 2 is present at its unit place. So write here 2 and 2 6 are 12. Again, this 6 is divisible by 2. We write here 2 and we write here 3. So in this way, you have to find out the factors of any number using the factor tree, and this is called as the factor tree. Isn't it easy to find out the factors of any number? No need to write down again. A few students ask me, sir, whether this 2 is divisible again by 1 and we have to write down the 1 and 2. No need to write down again 1 and 2, the two factors of 2 like this. So it is very time consuming and tedious. Only remember these steps. You have to write down these steps to find out the factors. Then we turn toward the 24. Look here. This is your first example. So what is your first step? Write down the 24 as it is. Divide it by 2 as 4 is at unit place. So it is divisible by 2 and we write here 12. As you know that just we have seen, look here, the factors of 24 are 2 and 12. Look here, 24, the factors we got here 2 and 12. So similarly, same the factors we got here 2 and 12. First we divided by 2. Again, this 12, look here, we just find out the 12 is present in the table of 2. So we write here 2, we write here 6. This 6 is divisible by 2, we write here 2 and 2, 3 is 6. If you don't know the table of 2, so what we do here? You just write down here like this 12, 2 6 are 12, and then multiply these two. These two are the factors of 12. These two are the factors of 12. So you draw these two lines. In one circle, you have to write down the 2. In another circle, you have to write down the 24. It means that 24 multiplied by 2, you got 48 like this. 12 multiplied by 2, you got 24 here. Similarly, 50, write 50 first, divide it by 2, as 0 is there, 2 2s are 4, 5 minus 4, we got 1 here, we put 0 over 1, so we got 10 here, 2 5s are 10, so we write here 10, 1, 0 minus 0, we write here 0 and 0, 1 minus 1, so we got the two numbers, that is two factors, 2 and 25, so draw two lines like this. So in first circle, write down the 2. In another circle, write down the 25. Again, divide this 25. As you know that the 5, a number having 5 is at unit place. That number is exactly divisible by 5. Again, I repeat it. A number having 5 at its unit place, that number is divisible by 5. So I divide this 25 by 5. 5 5s are 25. So right here, these two are the factors of 25. Divide into circle, that is 5 and 5. No need to write down again like this 1 and 5, the factors of 5. So in this way, we will find out the factors of any number by using the factor tree. This is called as the factor tree. I hope all of you understand this concept of prime factorization and factor tree. Now we will turn toward the common factors of number. This is again a most important part. Common factors. Find out common factors of 4 and 6. So first I write down the factors of 4. Factors of 4. As you know that 1 is a factor of every number. So first I write 4. Then in the table of 2, 4 is there, 2 to the 4. And at last, the same number, that is the number itself, is a factor. So I write here 4. Factors of 6. Factors of 6 is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 6. As 6 is present in the table of 2 and 3, 1 is always there and 6 is always there, the same number. So these are the factors, and the common factors, that means the numbers which are present in the factor of 4 and 6. So right here, common factors as, first I draw a circle to them, 1 is there, again 1 is there, 2 is there, 2 is there. So two factors are there, 1 and 2. In this way, we will find out the factors of 4 and 6. So this is a homework question for you. You will try yourself. If you find it difficult, then don't hesitate to ask me. Please mail us on sushiljoshi007@rediffmail.com. Homework. 12 and 16, common factor you have to find out. 20 and 50. C, 45 and 75. And D, 11 and 33. These four questions are given to us. If you find any difficulty, then please mail me at Sushil Joshi. Just a minute, I will @rediffmail.com. So here you can ask your doubt. If you are studying at grade 4 and 5, definitely you may ask me about this topic or any topic if you find it difficult. Now, how we will find out the common factors by using the prime factorization method? Look here. This is another a very beautiful example. Common factors using prime factorization method. Prime factorization method. So this is another best example. We'll learn how we will find out the common factors by using prime factorization. So let us take an example, 24 and 56. Suppose this question is given to us. So what is your first step? Your first step is draw a line like this. Here write 24, here write 56, and divide it by 2. As you know that the 4 and 6 are present at the unit place, so definitely this number, both the numbers are divisible by 2. So right here, 2, as you know that 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So 2 twos are 4, carry 5 minus 4, we got 1, and we put 6 over it. So 2 adds are 16. So right here, 8 here, 28. Again, 2 and 8 is there. Definitely, it is divisible by 2. 2 6 are 12, 2 ones are 2, and 2 4s are 8. So here we got 14 here. Again, 6 and 4 is there, divisible by 2. 2 3s are 6, and 2 7s are 14. Then look here. Here, now, here is 3 and 7. Both the numbers are different. So we cannot divide by the same number to both these numbers. So we have to stop here. If you find these numbers which are not divisible by the same number, so we have to stop here. Stop here. Then no need to divide it again. And these numbers are called as the common factors by using the prime factorization method. So common factor is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2 is equal to 8. So what is the common factor of 24 and 56? 8 is there. So like this you have to find out. Let us take another example. It will clear you the idea of common factors using the prime factorization method. Example number 2. Suppose this question is given to you. 15 and 95 is given to us. So what is your first step? First, draw a line like this. Right here 15, right here 95. So again, I divide it. As you know that 5 is at the unit place. 5 is present at its unit place. So right here 5, 5 threes are 15. Again 95, right here 95, 5 is there, 5 ones are 5, 4, 5 over there, 5 nines are 45. So I write here 19. Look here, these two numbers are different numbers, 3 and 19. So we cannot divide further by a same number. If you find out the two different numbers and we can't divide it further by another same number, so we have to stop here. Don't write stop, huh? So I will write it for your sake of convenience. Do not write here. Don't write this stop here. Only I will tell you stop here. And this is what is the common factor. Common factor is nothing but your 5. Common factor of 15 and 95 is 5. What is important fact? Note, you have to remember, whenever after dividing you get two different numbers which are not divisible by same number, divisible by same number, then you cannot do further calculation. Means stop there. You cannot do further calculation, means you have to stop there. And this is your common factor. If you remember this, definitely you will learn the common factor by using the prime factorization method. So, dear students, I hope all of you understand today's topic in a very clear way. So, at last, I will request you, if you like my video, then don't forget to subscribe and share it and press the bell icon. Thank you for watching the Math Magic.